Okay, so here we are in Premiere Pro CC, and I've just opened my project, and my sequence is not showing on the timeline. When this happens, the first thing you want to try is Soution One. So, though it may seem counterintuitive, Premiere Pro saves your sequences in with your media files. So you want to go to your project media panel, which is located on the left-hand side. Click on the two arrows, and it should show your project right there. You can also click on the project here up above if it's listed. And there you will see all of the files listed for your project. And included among them will be something that has an icon like this. That represents a sequence file. Multiple tracks represents a sequence file. So just double-click on that file, and your sequence is restored to the timeline. Okay, just say you wanted to edit the sequence, start working on it, you start moving things around, maybe you bring in another sequence to look at, and in the process, you've discovered, we'll just clear it out, in the process, you've discovered that your original sequence is no longer showing in the project media panel. If that happens during an edit, you're going to want to try Soution 2. Okay, so Adobe Premiere Pro saves 32 changes that you make during your edit. And not just changes in the editing panel, but changes across all panels, including the media panel, the project media panel. So all you need to do if you've lost your sequence from the media panel is to go up, click edit, undo, and it will restore your sequence into the project media panel. Double click on it, and it's returned back to the timeline. All right, I just want to stop for a second and say if you're getting some value out of this video, please don't forget to like and subscribe and or follow. Hit that bell for notifications so you get informed when the new videos and premieres are coming, and leave me a comment down below. Okay, in the next scenario, just say you find that your sequence is missing from the timeline, it's not appearing in the project media panel, and there is no availability of the undo function. It's grayed out. In that situation, you're going to want to try Soution 3. Okay, so here we have a situation where I've opened my project file. This is a different project. There's no sequence showing on the timeline. There are some files in my project media panel, but there's no sequence in there. And if I go up to edit, there's no undo function available, and that's because the undo cache is cleared when you close out your project. So that's normal. So in this situation, what you're going to do is go to File, then down to Import, and then you want to go to your project folder, which is right here in this case. And in there, you should see a folder that says Adobe Premiere Pro Autosave. So click on that. And then you'll start to see your project files. What you want to do is hover your mouse pointer over that and look at the date modified. In this case, it says 10/2/2021 at 8:13 p.m. So we want to find a file that's earlier than that because that will contain our sequence. So let's go back. Let's look at this file. This file says 10/2/2021 at 8:03 p.m. So we're going to select that and click open. And then Premiere Pro gives us this dialog window and we can import the entire project from that project file or we can just import selected sequences. There are some other options, but we're just going to choose import selected sequences. And so this will look through that project file to see what sequences are in there. And it will display those, and it's displaying this one. So we're going to select it, click OK, and that imports that sequence back into our project media panel, and it's right here. And I think this is two guys on a movie set dressed as doormen. Yep, that's what it is. Hey, who's that guy right there? Who is that guy? So this works very well when you have a sequence saved in a project file in that autosave folder. But what happens, you ask, when there is no sequence found in any of those files? That will be a reason to try Soution 4. Okay, for this solution, you want to utilize your operating system's search function. In this case, I'm using Windows 10, and I've got a search box down here. And you want to type in the name of your project file here. In this case, it's called SEQWTI, and I just had to type in SEQ, and it brings up all these files. So let's take a look at some of these. This one was modified 10/2/8/13 p.m. This one was modified on 10/5 at 5:35 p.m. So let's take this one. It goes back a little further. This was 10/2/8/03 p.m. And it's kind of cool. When you click on this, it automatically puts it back into your project media panel and then puts the sequence on the timeline for you. So this works very well, but if you find that you cannot find that sequence or that project file, there's a chance that it did get deleted from your machine, in which case you can still locate it. There is hope. You can get some really good recovery software, data recovery software online for free sometimes. And you just want to make sure if you use that stuff that you don't write anything or save anything onto your machine until that software has a chance to find it, or else you might overwrite it. So there you have it, four solutions for finding your sequences. Okay, I hope this video was helpful. Again, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Stay well, and I'll see you in the next video.